There's a growing political awareness in Nigeria, and evidence of this is the number of registered political parties in the country.
Now, recently, INEC formally presented certificates of registration to 23 new political parties, bringing the total number of parties to 91. But some Nigerians are of the opinion that having as many as 91 registered political parties may not be in the interest of the country. They say the number will make the electoral process cumbersome for INEC and the electorate.
While other concerns raised include a lack of clear-cut ideology by most political parties in the country, and that the participation of 91 parties in the 2019 general election might distort voting sequence, as some parties bear too much similarities in name. Well, do we need 91 political parties or not? Our guests right here in the studio will try to provide answers to the many questions that we've raised this morning. He's a 2019 presidential aspirant on the platform of the Providence People's Congress. Victor, hi. Good morning. Thanks for joining
us. Thank you for having me.
It's nice to have you join us.
Thank you for having me.
Okay, so do we need 91 political parties? Is it a sign of growing political awareness or just mere sentiments towards we need a share of the national cake? If we have a political party, then we have a bargaining chip with whoever.
Well, thank you for that question. It's a very, very relevant question, especially at a time like this. You recall that recently young people were advocating and agitating for, and they did get the bill. For me, I consider the bill a Pyrrhic victory. I don't know that it would change anything from what we have seen the last few days. They're not too young to be run. Yes, well, if you like, call it law now.
Yes.
So yes, the age has been lowered, but what else has changed? If you consider that you have to pay 45 million naira in an economy that has a minimum wage of 18,000. And then your schools are nothing but I don't even know how to describe the educational system in this country. And living is by the grace of God. You know, more often than not, we trust our religious houses and our traditional medicine practitioners and even our hospitals. When you consider all of that put together, you will and you know that there are people of integrity. There are people who mean well for this country, people who haven't stolen money from this country, people who haven't remained in power and continue to recycle themselves and their children since 1966, you know, then you understand why there is a need for, if you like, alternative platforms where they can manifest themselves. If I do not have 45 million, I couldn't have had that unless I wouldn't even steal, that's the truth. You know, so how would I have had a chance at this when I've already, the gatekeepers have already effectively made sure I don't have a chance by upping the ante to 45 million. And look at this, look at the level of impunity of the current administration where, I mean, and the two big parties. INEC told us clearly that 10 million that no party should put its presidential
above
10 million. You're aware of that. But yes. See the impunity of these parties, starting from the ruling party APC and their co-conspirators or cohorts, PDP, 12 million. So they have already flouted that regulation. You understand what I'm saying? Now, in flouting, they have said, to hell with INEC, excuse my language, okay? They have said, what INEC is saying is irrelevant. They are determined that no young person, no person of integrity, because if you truly worked hard for your money, you are not going to throw 45 million into just buying a form because you want to serve
people. Well, obviously, they have not been dipping their hands into their own personal pockets to buy the
form. Oh, so it seems.
In the case of President Buhari, for example, this group came up and bought the form for him. And
excuse
the same thing applies
me.
To
I mean, excuse me.
Yes.
Let me say this to you. There's no bigger drama theater than the Nigerian political space. I can tell you that. Okay, we know this game. We know exactly what they're doing. You know, some other person said 7,000 youths came on board. Excuse me. And so, getting back to the question, there is a need to, first, and also let's go back to the Constitution. There's freedom of association.
Yes.
Okay, so whether one party, five party, 1,000 parties, it is legal under the Nigerian Constitution. Mm-hmm. So I think if people want to associate under a different platform in order to seek power and express and seek expression for what it is they want, they're well within their rights.
All right, but if we see from the other perspective, yes. Just like you said, we had the INEC chairman here sometime, Professor Mahmoud Yakubu, and we asked him, and he said, well, INEC is only responding to what the law says.
Yes.
The people have the right. But if you look at it critically,
yes.
it is still INEC, because he said there are hundreds of registered associations who want to become political parties.
Yes.
It was INEC who used its discretion to say this qualify and that does not qualify. So at that point, it behoves, it is totally on INEC's table to say, okay.
There's also gatekeeping there, I'm aware of that.
Yeah, yes. there's supposed to be gatekeeping, but we are looking at the discretion. Couldn't they have used the discretion further to say, we have to limit it within a certain range where it is manageable?
No, they can't
do that.
We're talking about the issue of... No, they can't do that, which is why I told you about the laws. You cannot, I mean, it may seem wieldy and all of that, but remember, not every party is going to field a presidential aspirant, for instance. And many of the parties will, at best, operate at the local level, at the local government level, you know, and all that. So I think it's fine. Not everyone. At different levels and at different stages, people are going to be, you know, going into different parties and all of that. And when we do have true ideology, of course, not every party, most parties don't have. That's different from the party that I'm in anyway. You know, so...
Everybody would say about their own party.
No, I can tell you. I can tell you for free. I mean, most parties are just platforms. Many are special purpose vehicles. I'm sorry, with all due respect. But I know I've taken my time and arrived at where I am and all of that. But that's neither here nor there. The thing is that there must be some sort of ideological concurrence between the individual and the party.
And the party. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, he's going into this. Some sort of agreement, sort of, whether based on ideology or whatever it is. But you're where you're most comfortable, where you are out to realize whatever it is your objectives are politically. Mm-hmm. Some people need power to effect change. Some need power to bring power. Some need it to effect change in the environment.
We do understand that, you know, but when you say, yeah, not all the political parties will field presidential aspirants, but we're not even hearing from this many parties that, you know, they are looking at the local government, the local councillorship, and what have you. You know, they come up and they just come up with their presidential aspirants or candidates, as it were. It looks like everybody is just gunning for the highest level of governance.
As is right now, legitimately,
yes.
There's nothing wrong with having those 91 candidates.
Legitimately, that's well within their laws.
So there's nothing wrong with that.
Mm-hmm.
The thing is, for some, they just want to go local. Okay? It depends on their aspiration. If they have a strong enough candidate and they can go national, fine. Mm. Some just want to grab power in their own local environment, and that's it. Someone from the northeast or north central, for instance, may want power just to be able to stop the killings around that area. Okay, so the thing about the political process is you get into politics to grab power to effect change or to have a voice, you know, and to be able to do something for your people. That's what it is. People can choose to aspire at whatever. Parties can decide. Some parties have the ambition of operating at national level. Some have the ambition. I mean, until recently, in the Southwest here, if I may use a politician as an example, I'm using Tinubu as an example, for instance.
Yes.
His interest was mainly, until the alliance with Buhari, for instance, his interest was mainly consolidating power in the Southwest and making sure that power remains in the Southwest. Now, that is his focus. Mm. Some other person may want to say, Saraki, for instance, may just want to keep power within, make sure that whatever happens, he doesn't lose quarter. you know, for whatever reason, you know. So, and it's like that. So people have different reasons.
All right, we'll be going for the news update shortly. But before let me even narrow it down to you and maybe even your political party.
Yes.
Not so many Nigerians will say, the Providence People's Party is a very popular
party. Providence People's Congress.
People's Congress, PPC.
Yes.
But however, it is one of the political parties that sees itself as different from all the other ones that warrants it to register as a political party. It has its own ideology. So what is the PPC bringing on the table that is different from what any other political party would have brought?
Oh, I can tell you for free. I mean, this is a party that it says what it does. It means what it says and does what it means. Now, first of all, the motto of the party is do it right, get it right. Okay? It's a party that is founded on integrity. I can assure, on the form of the party, as you fill the membership form, it is stated there clearly, no money bags, which means you cannot come and hijack. If you come with your money, frankly, that is the first thing that would disqualify you. You can join, but you cannot hope to aspire because these are pens of integrity. You can't buy them over. No rituals, no godfatherism. No, it's stated clearly. So, ab initio, you know what you're coming in for.
Yeah.
And the thing is, the watchword there is integrity. We intend to do things right,
that we all look forward to seeing in political parties that is lacking.
Yes.
Does the PPC have that ideology that Nigerians are looking for?
Well, if you look at the motto, and I can tell you that what is wrong in this country is the fact that we do not do things the proper way. If we aim to do things right and get things right, you can begin to build everything around that simple ideology. It sounds simple, but on that leg will flow so many things, whether in government, whether in private life, whether in the process of awarding contracts, of making appointments and all that. If you aim to do everything right and based on integrity, you can never go wrong. Every other thing grows from that.
In Nigeria, when it comes to saying and specifying and recommending all of those, Nigerians is not new to Nigerians at all. It is in the area of acting it out and playing it out in practical terms that makes the difference. Like, one would say the president cannot be everywhere every time. So if we assume at the end of the day you go to the polls and then you win and then your political party becomes so popular, but then maybe somewhere in Benue or somewhere in Cross River or somewhere in Port Harcourt, so many things are happening or so many things will happen that don't reflect your ideology and your party. How would you handle that?
Oh, thank you. Something I never wanted to say, but I'm going to say it here. You know, the reason that there's so much impunity is that we only go after the small fishes, if you like. The real big cats, who are the ones that are the real corrupt people, go scot-free. If I were the president, for what happened at E.K. Clark's place, I would fire the IG. Not those policemen that have been victimized. And the reason is simple. You see, what I see a situation now where when anything happens, it's like a game of chess. The pawns are disposables, okay? And because they are disposable, so this impunity continues. If you hold the IG responsible for the acts of a corporal, police corporal on the street, you fire the first one, people think it's a joke, okay? Another impunity is committed by another, maybe sergeant on the street. You fire the next IG. Mm. Mm. People begin to think, okay, is this guy for real? By the time the third IG is fired, I guarantee you, the fourth IG will not sleep at night.
It may not even get to the point of even firing the second one or the third one.
You understand what I'm saying?
Let me bring this in because we're almost done, really. Okay. The issue of this proliferation of political parties.
Yes.
Don't you think many of these parties really should have been lobbying groups or pressure groups instead of political parties, pressure groups or lobbyists who can actually help in influencing policy and, you know, some of government's decisions instead of actually forming so-called political parties?
I agree with you, but what is a political party after all but a lobby group? Mm-hmm. That's exactly what the political party is. You have the Green Party,
for
instance.
That does not seek election.
No, you see, the only way to effect change, I use the word effect as in effectiveness, is to be in charge of power yourself. Why do you have the Green Party, for instance? If you're not in the, I'm talking about abroad now, where you have Green Party that, for the environment. Mm. They're there so that when they can bring laws, you know, and they can vote for laws on the environment. Mm-hmm. They don't necessarily have to go for the presidency, but they're there, you know, and they align with parties that are in favor of the environment. And so that is lobbying, but from within. In a country like Nigeria, you can't lobby from outside. It's like you're in a house and your landlord kicks you out. You want to begin to fight from outside? No, you can't do it. Hmm. So you've got to be in there, right in the ring, in order to be able to have a voice. There's so much killing in the Middle Belt right now. Who's going to speak for them? Mm-hmm. There's the double standard in the
That's what we're talking Who's about. You just raised the them? Example of how it's done abroad. In the US, for example, you have the pro-life, pro-lifers. You have...
That's why all the of only that, way it can work
That
here,
is ideology. But exactly. What kind of ideology can we really say we're putting forward, other than we'll provide good roads, electricity and all of that, which ordinarily should be
the fundamental things that... No, those are manifestos. You mistake those for ideologies.
You said your ideology is integrity. How does integrity...
No, no, no. The integrity encapsulates. If you do it right, you will get it right. Mm-hmm. And so to do it right, integrity will drive... You understand what I'm saying?
Yes, integrity will drive it. But in terms of specifics, are you telling Nigerians, whether it's your party or any other party for that matter, are you telling Nigerians this is what we stand for? This is what the Nigerian dream, what we believe it should be. And so this is the reason why you should vote for us.
Oh, I can tell you that's not a problem at all. You see, I can't go on here beginning to list
all the
things that are wrong. Mm-hmm. But what if you ask anybody today, one of the biggest problems in this country, mm-hmm. we talk about corruption.
Yes.
Okay? Uh-huh. And corruption is something that is not just endemic, but it's like a canker worm that is eating us.
All the parties are re-echoing that. Yeah. All the parties are saying corruption, corruption.
Saying is different from doing.
Okay.
Okay? I'll give you a small example. We're talking earlier. Look at the nomination process for this party, for instance. Other parties are using it to raise money and all of that. Mm. This party, for instance, says you can aspire if you are a person of integrity and you truly want to serve Nigeria. Mm. With about 500,000, you can get the nomination for this party. For governorship and the rest, for next to nothing. Mm. What is interesting is, even if you don't have the money to pay, if the party believes in you,
you have
as
the right,
a candidate, you don't
have
money,
have a chance.
The party will back you up, whether you have the money or not.
All right.
Now, what can be better than that?
Yeah, when it comes to integrity, I wonder who determines.
You might say it's subjective. I agree with you.
Yeah.
But you see, integrity is something that you see. It's not what you say.
It can also be perception.
No, while I agree with you...
It can also be perception.
Perception could be a reality.
Yes.
You understand?
It could also
be
a mirage.
But it stems. It stems from what you do, from what you say, and from what people say about you. Mm-hmm. Perception is mostly what... the image you put out there, not necessarily what you do or who
you
are.
Oh. We have to leave you here now because of time, but I know as time goes on, we'll have time to engage again for people to understand what the PPC stands for and what your dream for Nigeria is.
Oh, yeah.
We'll have that time.
To talk about that.
Victor Ojai, presidential aspirant for the Providence People's Congress. Thank you for coming.
Thank you for having me.